Folks, good afternoon. My name is Prajakt Raut. I am the Vice President at the Indian Angel Network. As many of you would know, that the Indian Angel Network is one of the largest and certainly most oldest angel network or angel platform in the country. We have about 50 plus members across different parts of the country, and some of them including in the US and UK and other parts of the world, and some in Singapore. We typically invest in concept stage companies or very early stage companies, putting in anywhere from 25 lakhs to about 5 crores. And what we do is we help, apart from the funding, we help them with mentoring and other support that would be required to scale up their ventures. So that's about the Indian Angel Network. So folks, today's session is about how to present a business plan to angel investors. And, you know, this is about, you know, first, so folks, I wanted to first check how many people understand the difference between angel investors and VCs. Yeah, Sukanya, if I would ask a couple of questions to people and if they were to respond, is there any way in which we will be able to either hear them or for them to give a signal saying that yes, this is available or not? Yeah, can people give a hand, please? So folks, how many people understand the difference between VCs and angel investors? And the reason I'm asking this question is because depending on what the understanding of the people is, I will then be able to structure my talk accordingly. Yeah. So folks, you can type in a response saying yes, no, or you can do a raise of hands and we can take it up accordingly from there. So the question is, do people understand on this call, do people understand the difference between angel investors and venture capitalists? Good, at least there's one answer which says no. Any more people who don't understand? So let me take a thing that most people will not have an understanding of them. You know, there are three different stages of a venture. One is what is called the idea stage or a concept stage, which is where everything is at a risk. Idea ye chalega ki nahi chalega, whether these people will be able to execute it or not execute it, whether this venture will scale up, whether this has a business case, whether customers will buy or not buy. This is what we call the concept risk stage of a business. After this stage has been passed, when you have initial customers, the product has come out in the market, is when building up stage of the venture. At these three different stages, different kinds of investors participate. At the very first stage, which is the concept risk stage, is what we have angel investors participate. These are people who will invest a little amount of money, small amounts of money, just barely enough for the team to get past the concept stage, product prototype, getting in the market with a little bit of traction, getting a few initial beta customers. That is the stage where angel investors participate. Angel investors could be either individuals, which is people who invest in their individual capacities. That could be, including, you know, people like a family and friends who invest in early stage ventures could also be considered angel investor. And then there are angel investors group like the Indian Angel Network, Mumbai Angels, Hyderabad Angels, where there is a collective number of individuals who invest in early or concept stage companies. That is what angel groups are. Now, depending on what stage the venture is in, that is the stage that you need to go to different investor groups. If you are a growth stage company where the challenges are not about identifying whether the market exists, whether the customers will buy, whether the business case is valid, whether the product will work, etc. At that stage, there is absolutely no point in going to, say, an angel investor group. However, on the other hand, if you are a concept stage company, you are still at an idea stage, there is no point in going to a VC. It's like, think of it like this. Think of it like a preschool, school and a college. All three are in the business of education. They are all about educating a person, but you go to each of these at a different stage of life. When you are a kid and when you need to understand the foundations of life, you go to a preschool. When you are a little more aware of the environment and need to enhance your knowledge and you need to grow, that is the time you go to a school. And when you want to really explore the horizons and opportunities of where life can take you further on is when you get into specialization, and that is the time you get into college. Similarly, at the beginning of the journey is when you go to an angel investor group, or what is called seed stage. After that, you go to VCs, and after that business has scaled up, you go to what is called late stage VCs or private equity fund. Now, one of the reason I'm spending time on this is because one of the biggest mistakes that we see people do is when they have a business to that they think is fundable, they immediately rush to a VC. And most of these VCs are, you know, visible, and you do a little bit of Google and VCs will come up. But like a 2-year-old, 3-year-old kid, no matter how intelligent that kid is, he cannot be admitted into a school. He will have to go through a preschool or a play school, you know, kind of an environment. Similarly, no matter how good your idea is or how good your business is, VCs are not geared to address that need at that stage. You will have to go to an angel investor group. Why angel investor group? Because angel investors are what we call participative investors. These are people who, along with the money that they put in, will be putting in a whole bunch of mentoring, advice, guidance, and everything else that you would require as a team to structure your business, to help you through the navigation. In the early stage of the businesses, there is a lot of uncertainty whether this price point would work or that price point would work, whether this target audience is right for my business or is a different target audience. If my business is not going according my business plan, is it because my value proposition was not right, or is it because my product was not right, was it because my pricing was not right, or was my communication right? So there's a lot of adjustment that needs to get done. And what angel investors do typically is, because they will participate in a lot more direct ways in your business, they will be able to provide you a lot more inputs as you go along. VC funds, on the other hand, are people who will participate with you at the growth stage. A lot of uncertainty about the business has already been taken out of the system. You have proven your product, you have proven your price point, your customers are done, etc. And what you need then is only a scaling up, and that is the time VCs come in. So first point is, understand what stage your business is in, and then figure out whether you need to go to a VC or whether you need to go to an angel investor. Now the question is, why do angel investors, or why do, you know, people invest in startups? Most people assume that angel investors, because the name is slightly misleading. Most people believe that they will invest because they have made a lot of money, and it is their, you know, it's almost like a social responsibility to give back to society, and therefore they will submit new entrepreneurs in doing that. Well, that may be partly true. You know, that's not exactly the reason why investors invest. Investors are individuals with surplus capital. What I mean by surplus capital is that they will have enough money to invest in many different asset classes. Nobody becomes just an investor saying that I will invest only in startups. They invest in a variety of asset classes. Some people will invest in real estate, commodities, stock markets, public markets, high yield debt, and all these kind of things. And along with that, they may invest in startups as well. Now, the reason, therefore, angel investors will also invest in a startup is because they want to make a profit, or they want to have a good return on the capital that they are deploying onto a startup. Any person who has got surplus capital, they will be looking at making more money in, you know, it's a portfolio of blended investments: stock market, real estate, commodity market, high yield debt, government bonds, and all that kind of assets that are available for people with a lot of money to invest in. Assuming that a person is likely to get about 20-25% return if they were to invest in the stock market over an extended period of time, if per year return is going to be about 20-25%, their hope would be that they are able to beat the stock market with at least 5 or 10% margin. So anybody who's investing in startups will expect to get about 30% return on the money that they invest in. And of course, you know, angel investors are also interested in supporting startups. But the prime reason they invest is because they are interested in making a good return on the investment that they make. And therefore, while you present to angel investors or any investor group, when you talk about your product, it is important to talk about the product, but it is equally important to talk to them about the business case for the concept or the product that you're talking about. Why should they invest in your business, and what is it that makes this a good business opportunity for them to invest in? Now, the next question therefore is, how much return do angel investors seek from the investments that they make? Again, I would have liked to make this interactive, but because this format isn't presented, I'm one second. So how much investments do investors, how do I get the build on to this? No, okay. So typically investors, when they invest in a startup, they would expect up to 8 to 10 times of the money that they invest in a startup as their returns. And the reason is simple. It doesn't mean that they are greedy. It doesn't mean that they're trying to get exceptionally high profits. But let me give you a very simple mathematical example in terms of why this is a reasonable return for them to expect. Assume that they invest 1 crore, and I'm just simplifying it mathematically to prove the point. If they were to invest, say, 1 crore rupees in 10 startups, they would have in that year invested about 10 crores. Assuming that they were going to get about 25% return in the stock markets, which means that if they had invested in the stock market this 10 crore, they would have in a year got 2 to 2.5 crore rupees as they had invested, which means that in a 3 or 4 year period, this 10 crore would have become anywhere between 20 to 25 crores. That is the opportunity cost, meaning that if they had invested that money somewhere else, that is the kind of money, that is the kind of growth of capital that they would have got. Now, this 10 crores, assume that they have invested in 10 different startups, 1 crore each in 10 different startups. In startups, because the risk is very high, the chances of failure are significantly high as well. Out of every 10 startups that angel investors invest in about 2 or 3 years time, 6 or 7 or 8 will die down. And that has been the trend across the world. There is no way for anyone to predict and say that I have invested in 10 companies, all of them are successful or most of them are successful. But that's the risk that you have to take. So if you want to get 2 successful deals, you have to invest in 20-30 deals. There is no way in which you can get, you invest in 3 companies and expect 1 or 2 of them to be successful. So as a result, think about it, 10 crores invested, 1 crore each in 10 different companies, and of which in 2 or 3 years time, 7 companies have closed down. Reh gaye 3 companies. Out of those 3 companies, maybe 1 company has barely returned the capital, just about surviving and stuff. So therefore, in 4 years time, when this investor wants to exit from your investment and wants to liquidate his holding in your capital, these 2 companies that are remaining have to make up for the losses that he has incurred on everybody else and give that investor the profit as well. And that is the reason these 2 companies will have to give him about anywhere from 10 to 25 crores, which means that they will have to give anywhere between 8 to 10 to 12 x 10 times the return that they have originally invested in. Now, that's the only way the game can be played. Every investment, therefore, that an angel investor makes, hopes they do it because they believe a particular company has the capacity to return anywhere upwards of 5, 6, 7 times the money that they invested. Only when they invest in those kind of companies will they be able to get a decent return of the capital. I'm going to spend a little more time on this part because everything else is something that can be easily run across. But this is a very important point for people to understand as to what makes a good deal for the investable. Now, one of the mistakes that most people do, first of all, don't have a perspective that this is the kind of return that angel investors would be looking for. And therefore, a lot of times they come with business, but I will be profitable in 9th month, therefore I will be in 2nd year, it will be profitable, I will have 50% gross margins. And we check what their scalability is, then they are talking about maybe 5 crores revenue, maybe 10 crores revenue in 5 years time. Assuming that you are in a business, 4 times valuation, you know, three or four of your revenue. So in 5 years time, if you become a 5 crore company, then the value is 20 crore. If somebody had invested 1 crore in your company, 5% equity in your company, in 4 years time, that money would still become 4 crore. So it's not good investment for them. If they had got 20% in your company for that 1 crore that they had invested, if 5 years valuation has become just 20 crores, it's still 4 crores within that. Assuming in a situation that they have invested in 10 companies and only living, they have invested 10 crores and 5 years, if both these investments give me 4 crores each, rather than making it my 10 crores and 25 crores, all I have got, this audio seems to be breaking. So in that, in your investment, they would have gained 4 times, but overall as a portfolio they would still be in a loss, because they've invested 1 crore in 10 companies, but they have got you and the other companies 4 crore, which is 4 times, but it still doesn't make sense. So unless 1 or 2 companies in their 10 investments are likely to give them 8 to 10 return, it does not make sense for angel investors to invest in startups. Only way they can do it is start taking bigger risks, which invest in 10 companies, assume that 6 or 7 or 8 will fail, and 1 or 2 companies will do that. But they will expect a return from each of the companies, and therefore the only factor that angel investors look for when deciding whether this is a good investment opportunity, apart of course many other factors and team, is whether the business is scalable and this is to be a large company as time goes by. So therefore, if you are pitching to angel investors, you ask them that you will be creative for them. It is not just about saying that, look, this is such an interesting product, this is an, you know, valuable service that I'm providing. My head looks better than everybody else, but you have to tell them how you will service and what do you get able to be able to. At this stage, profitability, as I explained to you, is not important, because unless the valuation company increases, there is no due for the investor into. What do I do with 50% returns on 50% gross margin if all I have is 20% of your company and valuation of your company is, you know, 10 crore after many years? I would still be building about 2 crore worth of equity in that company. Now, if I'll move on to how to actually present a plan to investors, I'm going to rush through some of these so that we can lot time for Q&A. Typically, in forums, whether angel groups or an individual company that you have, an individual VC fund that you are presenting, you get about 20 to 30 minutes for presenting your case, 30 minutes for discussing after that. But what I tell my companies is that you have only 30 seconds to and the rest is time to tell your story. If you do not get that person's concentrate attention, here's the first opening lines of your presentation that clearly communicate to the investor what specific and why this opportunity for them. Not about the product, not about people talk about the problem that they're addressing, people talk about the product and the options to better. But unless you are able to explain to them why this is a business opportunity and why this will make a valuable business, they are going to be interested. Therefore, practice that one line. In a 20-30 minute pitch presentation that you will have, keep some time for Q&A. So if for presentation to about 15-17 minutes and keep 3 minutes for Q&A. If 1 hour or 5 minutes, whatever time, keep 30 minutes or keep half the time for Q&A, because most people will not know the needs of your business. They will therefore have to ask questions for understanding to figure out whether this is good business or not. Forward on to this, I'm going in. Okay. Now, in many cases, most people start talking with giving an overview of the market and how large the size of the opportunity is. In most cases, people know where things are. So, for example, if you are in the e-commerce business, there is no point giving data. The number of individuals in India, the number of youth in India, the size of the apparel industry in India, all that most people know. When you know that these are going to be obvious, you don't really need to illustrate it. Just get to the core of what it is. However, if you are in a newer category in which people are unable to know about what they're about the industry, for example, if you are creating a new technology for knee replacement, most likely the size of the market, how people are likely to get knee replacement, how many people in the US, etc., or wherever you are to be selling this technology to. And therefore, it might be important for you to present it. But if you're setting, say, for example, if you're creating a service restaurant, or if you're doing a mobile app, or if you're doing an e-commerce company, where most people will know what the size of the opportunity is, don't waste time in doing. Focus the business around concept or the product or your service. Most people think that the product or the service that they are talking about is the business. These are two different things altogether. Product is the core of business, but business has to be built around it. A business is about whom are you going to sell, how are you going to sell, how much money you will make, what are your cost structures, and you know, those are the kind of things that make the business around that entire. Yes, while explaining what your product is, quickly move to explain the business around that entire thing. Is to talk, what are you going to do with the concept, which sets the tone for the concept. Why is this concept important? Why is this a need? What is the need that you're addressing, etc.? How are you going to make money, which is the business case? A business pay how much and to whom? That is the description of a business case. You have to be very clear in terms of on the product that I'm selling or the service that I'm selling, whom am I? So, for example, it's not important. What is important to say, I'm going to make 60 lakhs of revenue, I'm going to make 1.6 crores of revenue, in the third year I'll have 5.8 crores. All those numbers would be fine. But if you are doing a B2B business, you're selling enterprises, investors would want to understand whether 60 lakhs is coming from 10,000 rupees in customers, is it coming from, you know, 1 lakh rupee into 60 customers, or coming from, you know, 5 lakhs into 2 customers, or whatever that. If you are doing a B2B solution or B2C solution, what you need to buy something, maybe an app or something else they're going to buy, you need to put in there in terms of what is the, how many customers are you going to get, what is the period of this payment, is this, when you're going to charge say 60 rupees per download, is this a time, is this an annual fee, what is the percentage that you expected in terms of repeat purchases, what is the percentage expected in terms of people falling out, etc. You need not have all the details on the presentation, but when you are talking about these, some things that you want, you have to illustrate and move on, because that's the What you want to give investor is the confidence is that you understand the business around the entire thing. The next point that investors want to know is the size of the opportunity or what is the potential. Now, this is different from what size of business you want to do. So you may say, okay, I'm doing 1 crore in this year, 2 crores next, 5 crores in year three, and 25 crores in year five. That is what the size of your business is. However, in the market that you are addressing, investors want to understand what is the overall size of the market. This 5 crores that you have to do in year 3 or 25 crores that you are going to do in year 5, is that 25 crores out of an 80 crore market or is that 25 crores out of a 100 crore market? If people have an understanding of what the size is, be able to take a more educated view on whether that 25 crores is possible. So if you say that I'm going to 25 companies, size of the market is about 1,000 crores because these are this many people, they will buy so much and so on and so forth. And when you say that the market is 80 crores and there's a 25 crore, you know, that you may be able to do it, but it seems like a very difficult one. Changed in your business, but the external environment around it puts a very risk factor towards these cases. Then you will need to understand. The reason why it is important for you to state very clearly is if you don't state it and the investor doesn't ask, they might assume things that may be, it may actually be a 100 crore opportunity and investor may think that it's a 100 to 100 crore opportunity and therefore risk may go up 4 times in terms of. What is very important for investors to understand is how you are going to implement this entire project, which is your operating plan, what is your organization plan, how are you going to plan your resources, how are you going to, why? Because that gives indication of cost structure and therefore they will need to have an understanding of how much money you need. Typically at the angel, the amount of capital that you should raise should be as much as that is enough for you to go to the things. A lot of stage companies saying, oh, we want 10 crores or we want 5 crores. First year, 2 years, we want to create our business and after that, we want to rapidly expand. And that is a good strategy. But from a funding strategy, take your investments into two different stages. Take the first stage as only as much money that you need to concept and the surrounded, which means all the assumptions that you're making. If I reach 100 people, 20 of them will come to the site, 5 will try the product, will buy. Each of those who buy will pay 200 rupees, they will buy, frequency of purchases will be once in a quarter. So these gross margins will be this much, my cost of customer acquisition, all these are assumptions. In the first raise, as you would recall, to test out your assumptions and a bit of maybe 30-40% from the money that you require. In the second round is when you should mind for scaling up part, and that's the kind of investment breakup or strategy you should have. Now, what should you include in your presentation? I mean, typically will be different templates that you will see online. But broadly, I will give you three things that you want to present. And of course, these are 10 points. But the three things are, one, what are you going to do? Second is, how are you going to do it? And the third is, how are you going to make money in doing it? These three things that investors want to understand. Now, whether for saying that you need 4 slides, 10 slides, 20 slides, it doesn't really matter. As long as you are able to quickly communicate to me, to the that customer, ye kaise hoga aur isme paise kaise banenge, and there you see this template that I have created. It captures the story which helps investor understand these three points, which is the team who's going to be doing it. When I say team, ideally invest in quality. If you are an individual, if you are a single individual doing it, you may get investment. The chances of you investor or fund investors, if you are a lone soldier, are significantly lower. And in the market, your competition is doing the same product, but when you're pitching for a investment, your competitor is other startups who are raising money from that same group. So while you make a quick service restaurant and you may be doing a chain of coffee stores in colleges, but your competition at raising money could be a mobile app that is doing health checkup in remote places as well. You're competing for the same pot of money that people will invest in. And if there is a team available, people are likely to invest in a stronger team. In fact, and I'll elaborate on this one later on, there is a saying in the VC world that they will rather put money in an A quality team with a B quality plan than a quality team with an A quality plan. The reason is this, because nobody's business plan is working the business plan. There's all the adjustments that need to be made, things that you plan don't work out in the market as well as you had planned it, etc. And therefore, team is required to make the adjustments. Size of the opportunity, business model. Business model is about who will pay, how will they pay, to whom will they pay to. Competitive landscape, you are competing, needs to be done. You need to talk about your operating plan. You need to talk about the risk factors that will make this business not succeed. What are your funding needs? And more importantly, the investor, what has the potential? When you say exit potentials, meaning how does the investor make money? Let me give you an analogy. When you invest, say, for example, when you buy Reliance in the stock market, you buy shares today and you can make money only if you are able to sell those shares to somebody else, less than you had bought it. We see angel investment work. Angel investors put money and they take shares, and they will be able to make money only if somebody else buys the share. That is called the exit as far as the investor is concerned. However, Reliance shares you can sell to somebody in the public market, stock market. There is no stock market listing startups. Therefore, somebody has to find a buyer to buy the share. That is what exit potential means. For angel investors, typically exit would be another VC investing in the company or a strategic making an investment in that company. So what do you invest? This is how you present to them. What is it that they're looking for? First and foremost, their criteria is teams think they can bet on. It is quality of people investing in. Of course, the business has to be good, you know, the potential has to be good, the product has to be good, all of that. But with all of those put in together, even if it is a world scale concept or most innovative product technology, is this case is strong, need is very strong, and all that, team is not good, investors are unlikely to feel comfortable investing. Ideas and concepts mean nothing PowerPoint level unless you have the ability to execute on the ground extremely well. So they need teams with a deep passion for the domain, because that's the only way you will be able to survive the challenging times. And no matter how good your business looks growing quarter on quarter every year, there are not one single anybody has ever seen this world where for the next 5 years you will keep on growing. Every single business plan that we see has the same thing. Is quarter mein na quarter se thoda zyada uske. Everybody is always talking about growth and growth and growth and growth and growth, and it does not have any. Nor does it happen for Narayan, it happened for Sunil Mittal, nor does it happen for Bill Gates, nor does or whatever. There are always challenges from the business plan you have made. Things will go up and down in some way or the other. The seasonality, there are challenges, things don't go right, and all kinds of things will happen. Unless you have plan for the business, things will not work out well. Investors look for plans with practical milestones, but with large aspirations. Say that, you know, Gartner says market is 80, therefore I will be a company in 5 years time is all fine, but kaise hoga is more important as for investors, which means okay, theek hai, I want to be a 500 crore company in 5 years time, and it is possible, but yaar next uske next quarter mein kya targets for the next 6 months? What are goals and how are we going to get to the first year itself? When you start taking those first initial steps, will you know whether you are going on to your milestones as well? So both are important, long-term vision and short-term execution. Investors look for teams with focus in initial phases. Typically, we see a lot of business where the entrepreneurs say, oh, when we are doing this, we will also be able to do this, and we'll be able to also do that, and we'll also be able to do that. I'll give an example. To give a presentation by somebody who was going to make from jasmine, lavender, and other flowers in cash. Excellent team with a deep understanding of that stuff. And rather than focusing on the wanted to get into manufacturing cosmetic on their own, manufacturing of food fragrances of their own and stuff, which is a completely different area altogether where they have no expertise or no competence at all. But it is possible, you can do anything that. The reality is that people are able to do multiple things together. So you could be that 1 out of 100. There is no way for the investor to believe that you are that 1 out of 100. And they prefer teams which are focusing on doing one rather than trying to do multiple things. Investors look for a strong implementation plan because ideas mean nothing. I can give you 20 ideas and just you have a way of doing that idea well. There is no way in which it can be, you know, business. So, saying that, you know, according to Technopack, this is a 5,000 crore market in India, all that is to know. But, I mean, if it's a market of 5,000, you know, crores, that's, had the market not been 5,000, market in 1,500 crores, would you not have done the business? Of course, you would have done the business still then. Had it been 500 crores, you would still have done the business. So, there's no point in looking and throwing Gartner numbers. It is how am I going to get my company off ground? How am I going to build a foundation? Where are my first 1,000 customers going to come in from? Or users going to come in? First, if I'm selling to large corporates, who am I selling to? Selling to companies is one thing, but saying that, you know, people have granularity in the thinking. When you say companies, say I'm selling to IT companies, I used to companies like Infosys and Wipro that are 100,000 people each, are you selling mid-tier companies that are say 2,000, 3,000, 500 people, or are you selling to 20 to 200 people? Because selling to each of these categories is a very different volume altogether. Investors teams that have a very clearly stated goals and tasks. Like I said, you know, if you want to be 200 crores, 300 crores, that only explains the size of the aspiration. Hoga nahi hoga kisko pata. 100 crore karne ki koshish karo, shayad 70 ho jaye, shayad 200 ho jaye. Kisko pata. That is only a directional number in terms of saying that broadly that is where we want to go. And it will fall in the place as you move along, you will make adjustments. But what is important is, if you have to go around that, there are some immediate things that will need to get done. What are you going to do in the next 3 months? What are you going to do in the next 6 months? And that, but in terms of saying that broadly we will go and acquire customers. 20 customers that we are going to go after. We have started talking of what we are looking for on warm options to the end companies. To them, we are going to pitch with this. We are going to tell them to try our product 3 months and then if they like it, this is what they will pay us. That is a very practical goals and task. People like that. Investors want to see practically what you are going to do in the market. They want to really understand how much fund is required, what it is going to be used for and what it will achieve. Which means if you say I want 1 crore and this will last for 1.5 year, is a good answer but doesn't anything for the investor. What they need, okay, this 1 crore is going to last me for a year and a half. 30% of this is going, will be built on building the product. 20% of it is going in building the team, salary and operating expenses, etc. The rest or whatever that percentage is. And the rest of the put into sales or marketing or whatever that is you're going to do. When we end of 18 months, we are done with this money, we have achieved a customer base of so many numbers, each paying us so much amount, and therefore our revenue, relative revenue in 18 months will be this much, and by 18th month we will be on a track of X lakhs or X crore every month on month. So which means, say, assume saying that a cumulative revenue will be say 1 crore in 18 months. Right, and we will be with say 10 lakh per month or 20 per month, which means you are next year to achieve a turnover of about 2.5 to 3 crores. That's the kind of granular always remember, it is very difficult to build a company with just one round of funding. Most people come back to us with saying that, oh no, our plan is so strong that 13 months we are not going to require any more money. This money we will become profitable. Rarely does that happen. In most cases, 19 cases require capital. And finally, investors invest in teams that they believe that they can, you know, trust, which means clearly stating what you know. Stating what you don't know is very relevant and very important for investors to understand. Why? Because as I explained earlier, angel investors are what we call participative investors. They like to work with you, they like to help you and guide you, mentor you, and that is the reason that they are participating in startups. They recognize business plans don't work in the office. They recognize that if business plan is a good report, things will go on and they will have to, teams jump in when I say go wrong, it does not necessarily mean go away from the business plan necessarily bad. It doesn't mean that it is only about, I had projected a revenue of 60 lakhs and this is. It could also mean that I had projected 60 lakhs, but it has gone into 2 crores. A lot of times, companies scale up beyond what they had planned for is also when they fall into challenges. Now, these are all happen. You could be below your business plan, you could be above your business plan, or you could be slightly anywhere in between. That's the reason why you need investors to work, or investors at least at this stage, to work very closely with you, and that is the reason they work with teams that they have that they believe that they can have a good chemistry with, and the trust is going to be very, very critical in doing all successful teams that go on to raise second round of funding beyond angel stage typically have very, very healthy relationships with their investors. So that's the point. Just to summarize, it's not about a product, it's not about the idea, the concept. All that is interesting and that will be a good starting point, but nobody invests money in the purchase of a great idea or because it's a great concept. People, it's because they see that this is a good business case, and therefore when you present investors, you have to present why this is a good business case around a good, interesting idea. That investors will invest only high quality team aspirations. It could be a great team, but you may have very modest aspirations and not confident of scaling it up. Or you could be a hawa mein baate wala, with large aspirations, but with no practical view in terms of what could happen. And nothing against management considerably investors are very, very. Execution capabilities of people in consulting for two, and the reason kursi mein baithke dekhe or making PowerPoint presentations without having slogged in the market in terms of being street and making a sale. There are, however, enough management consultants or people without operating experience previously who have been able to go and build good teams. But if you don't have operating experience, it is important for you to give the investor the confidence that you have it in you, or you have revenue to do operating the things that I in large business there is specialization. You are in this particular department or in that particular department. But I tell our startups that when you are a founder of a company, your designation is CEO, and it does not mean in a chief officer. It means chief everything officer. You are the marketing person, you are the sales person, you are the product person, you are the technology person, you are the finance and accounts person, you are the corporate governance person. Everything needs to be done. Therefore, it is very important for you not to be an order-giving person, you know, set up people, but you have to be very result-oriented and get things done. And that's what investors would be. And the last point, invest in clearly defined plans with very, very, very practical milestones. Large patience and a long-term vision and all that is directional. Hoga, nahi hoga, it all remains. But what you can control and what people can look at and compare your or evaluate quarter by quarter or month basis, how are you going to go about it? And that's the way to build a business. Quarter by quarter, look at things, execute, assess whether you're going there, work for the next quarter, and definitely keep on making adjustments as you know along. Net, what should be our goal of the investor presentation? But investors should get back that, hey, I think this is a great, I think the large, it's a opportunity, but and I think this team is something that I would like to bet on. If you have these things covered in the investor mind, you have a reasonable chance of them with you for an investment discussion. If either of these three things don't work, either of these, it's not just about one of these three things, if any of them don't work, the chances of you getting are absolutely negligible. A great in the large market without a great concept doesn't work. A great concept, great team, but the size of the market is small, doesn't work. Great concept, large market, doesn't work. All three of them have to with. And the reason together, I mean all three of them have to be together together in a startup business. For a startup to succeed in the market, 20 things to work right. For a startup in the market, one of those 20 have to work wrong or have to go wrong. And therefore, all of these three things are important as far as a investor is concerned. I'm done with my presenting. We can open up for me. Yeah, so my contact details are like that you can see. A few minutes for question and answers. Happy to take any questions So there's a question that has been typed from Valor Institute of Technology. How receptive are the startups? Well, there's not a single category named today where investors will say that we are not interested in this category. We are not. Again, the basic fundamental principles of what I spoke of today is a concept that is addressing a need, size the market opportunity large. Is the business case around is good? And since you asked about doctors, let me say, assume that you are selling clinic management software doctor and that you're selling it for say 2000 rupees a month as a fee, you know, then here you're making 24,000 rupees from that that particular doctor. What it is to sell to that customer is going to be the what is amount, how much is going to start, is what the business case will be about. And if the business case is good, if the customer addresses a real need and the market is large, yes, it would be interesting. Yes, a short answer to the question, absolutely. Health, education, infrastructure, nutrition, food, some of the business, mobile, telecom, these are some of the categories will have a that have a It depends in terms of whether it is important for an can everybody else see the question? Okay. So the question was whether you can get angel investors to their facility before they make an investment decision or before they pay. Well, before you, it's going to be very difficult for angel investors to come to your facility. See, typically any angel group, you get up 350, 400 plans every month. Only a few of them are good. Nobody knows which plans are going to be good, which plans are not going to be good. And therefore, the question typically will be about hearing your story. Why is this a good business case for people to be in? Once there's sufficient interest, once you have experienced a good business for them, is when they'll be able to say, okay, I would like to understand more. If your product or concept is such that it requires people to come and visit your facility, certainly they would. I mean, say for example, if you're doing an e-commerce venture and you have a very good warehouse, there's no point in an investor coming because this is what they're going to do. Doing, say for example, some biotechnology innovation which requires to be shown in a high-tech lab and how these things are getting done and so on and so forth, there may be interest in people doing it. But this is what happens in what is called the stage of due diligence. Due diligence is about saying that, look, these are the things that have been the presentation and discussed in our conversations. And figure out how true these are and whether this is really, the case. So, the technical due diligence, for example, if you're, for example, making robotic arms for the auto industry, in which case due diligence will happen, either in your facility or your customer's facility. Yeah. Are there any more questions? Can we take one more question? Sorry, I'm not able to understand the question. Can you type it out? I will read it out. And can you type the question? Why don't you type out the question? In the meanwhile, there are other questions that are typed. I will take the question. How about the stem cell entity? This again, IKP, LSI. So yes, the answer is yes. All of these are entities that will have however, you need to recognize that there are some businesses where the capital costs are significantly higher. For example, if you are a power generation a company that is hydropower, that cannot be done with small investments. You would need significant capital for doing that. And therefore, the investor, the kind of investment that required may be beyond the scale of that person invest. Or it may be more suitable for project finance or some organizations rather than funding. So this as well. Understand how much amount you, and I'll add my contact details on the slide. I'll be happy to answer any questions that are specific to our needs. I'm taking the next question on this. Present single person, how do they evaluate the team? Yes, that's a good question. Still, three or four founders or two or three founders, all of them should be there at the presentation. Yes, one person should present, but each one of them should talk one or two points about whatever the area of thing is. Now, how do investors decide whether on quality of the team, if there is only one person who has gone, Imbatore and the presentation is Delhi, all can't travel, one has gone, then investors don't write a check. I think this is a good idea, here's a check. It is typically a lot of due diligence, a lot of discussions to understand whether the chemistry matches and everything happens, and they would decide to make an investment. They would trust the team. A top question that typically comes in, and I will, while it has not been asked, I'll put it saying that, is it important for all the 100% involved in the company? The answer is a yes and a no. Doing other work, the investors will not invest. Practically speaking, the other members may not have the ability to take a salary or to live on very minimal salary, etc., and therefore they will be working. But if there is a commitment saying if get the fund, then we will immediately leave our respective jobs and get in. Those things are possible, but it will come in as what is called condition means that you fill that condition and that you come in. Okay, the next question is A0 services in the STB Pune. Is it advisable to approach B2B and B2C markets simultaneously? Well, you know, the interesting part of entrepreneurship or business is that there is no right answer to that. It all depends on the circumstances and what is your, you know. Now, while the opportunity may exist for both B2B as B2C markets, the reality is starting up, you always going to be resource starved, and your capacity to manage challenges, complexity of the businesses is going to be limited. So today everything is possible. Practically, it would be wiser to select of get your feet wet onto that, understand the complexities, understand the challenges, your business rough edges end out, and then target the market. How do you present this to the investor? You present it as an opportunity which has both B2C and B2B components, but in your practical milestones and going on, while opportunity is there for B as B2C, in the next 6-12 months, whatever, we are going to build our foundation by focus, and that's perfectly right. The next one I'm going, it's from Transcell Biologistics. The question is also how angels develop trust in the presenters on the team with interactions that are interactions only. Yes, that's true. Starting point journey. So the question is, how do you how people understand whether this team can be based on investors? Don't happen on the basis of one interaction. The story, the relationship begins with that one interaction to give the investor the confidence that this is a team that they would like to bet on. But to invest, there's a lot of dinner meetings, lunch meetings, deep interaction sector. That's various things in terms of your abilities, your thing. It's not just about the investor. You also have to like the investor, right? Because unless there is going to be good chemistry and good understanding between both of you, this is not a relationship for either of you. And their trust is built over time. It's not something that will get quickly. The trust will start getting the first initial ones. Next one is PhD Victor. Is it angel funding even if you are funded through other sources like DST? Of course, yes. DST, etc., give grants which are enough to develop a prototype for the initial stages of the company, and things that are available. And often companies require more money than what would be covered by DST. In any case, if DST or TD or any of these grants have been given to you, it always takes anybody else has invested in your company, including a friend, ex-boss, or a customer who has put in some small amount of money in that. It gives the investor confidence of that not only that other people believe this is a good business, also trust you as an individual, especially if it has come into, in many cases people have built businesses by taking small monies from their ex-bosses, ex-colleague, including sometimes ex-customer or as well as investors. Those are strong signaling tools as far as investors are concerned. And the last question, Sagar Institute of Technology, the question, can you give some sample plan templates which can teach the students of engineering to prepare a plan? Yes, if you go to the internet or if you go to my, you will get enough on my blog you'll get enough templates and also to do that. On the Indian Angel Network website, there's a guiding document which is the 10 things that your plan needs to cover. My presentation, which okay, so on my so anybody wants a presentation, just write to me and we will send you that presentation. I'll also send you a template, but go to indianangelnetwork.com and you will see what is called a guide document. That will give you a good overview of what is required.
It was actually a good presentation with a lot of information getting passed on the website.
You
see, I have a couple of questions. Number one is, you see, when you are investing about 25 lakhs rupees from your side, how much actually money you want the team to put into the business? I'm talking of only liquid cash.
Not at all. So there is no question of wanting the team to invest. See, what the investors look for in the skin in the game, as they call it, is the team's commitment. If you do not have money, you do not have anything, none is expected. But if you are driving around in a Honda, you are asking for products without putting in products from your side, that will be a question, be a concern. So it's not important for others, for the founders to invest when somebody is putting in. No, the answer is no. It is important for the founders to demonstrate the commitment that they will venture. In case there are challenges, and challenges will be there in every, no plan ever works, it has been constructed. There will be challenges. So how does the team ensure that there is enough commitment and to stay with the venture? And typically, so if it's a anything can be given, then you need to take a bet on the gut and the patch of the owners. But in profit, who's earning say 2 lakh rupees a month in a corporate, then that person's ability to or willingness to take the salary cut to go maybe 50,000-75,000 rupees is commitment that will be enough to show investors that. But if somebody comes and says, look, I was getting 2 lakhs, I would like to come and do my 15% increase in salary, or I want to name, that would be a difficult one for investors to buy. Not because of the money involved, but because of the whole principle of saying that what is your skin in the game. However, there could be situations where saying that I would have agreed to a salary cut, but my expenses are, so somebody is earning 1 lakh rupees and it says, I would have 40,000-50,000 salary, but this is my family situation and this is what I need, but these are my commitments. 70,000-80,000, it won't work for me from a life point of view. That kind of conversation investors would be open to do it. So the short question to your question, is anything required to be invested by an entrepreneur when an investor invests? Does it answer your question, sir?
Very much. Yes. The second point is, let us say that you have invested your money and you have actually taken about 10% equity in the business. Now what is happening is, you are finding that the business is actually not going beyond 5 crores annual sales turnover, even after what you call the 5 crores of period.
Okay,
now,
sir.
What will you do with your equity? Because your equity could be sold in the market. And
Concept risk meaning whether this idea will work, whether this team will be able to deliver it, whether the pricing works, whether the product works, whether the customers repeat purchase, they are able to service, all of the risks are there. And as I said in the beginning of my presentation, if investors in 10 companies, there were 6 companies closed down by the second, third year, 5, 6 or 7 of those companies closed down. Surviving गाड़ी है कैसे जैसे करके सो इनिंग राइट ऑफ द रीजन व्हाई आई मेंशन इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन दैट इन्वेस्टर्स इन ऑल द कंपनी दैट दे इन्वेस्ट इन लुक एट गेटिंग इट टू यू नो 15 इज द रिटर्न ऑफ द सो इफ somebody invest 25 lakh they would expect that 25 in for first time towards why because that kind of goal they have will they be able to make money despite 6-7 struggling on or fail so the winners have to not only for them also the other losses but that's the only way the game can be played you cannot say I will choose companies that will become winners because nobody knows who will become a winner what will happen. When you invest 20 companies maybe two of them will succeed if you want to say I will invest 20 more says another question that is asked it's K0 Tech Services since 1 month our product launch 3 B2B tiers on our way and 2 B2C sales we are still firming up as faces new challenges it is now correct time to approach external it depends I don't have enough data from this, to answer your question but I'll know on the mail IDs that you've seen and you know so specific questions regarding your ventures let's take client send me a mail and we respond back to you if there are any generations that we can take it at this how much time do you have Abhishek okay so questions we can you know so is PhD Coimbatore do the angel network also mentor of course give me of become mentor or invest in angel group is because they will be you know mentoring the teams meeting so the way the angel group is especially in the angel network is if some company requires crore in funding or requires 8.5 crores in funding they could be 10 12 15 investors that collectively invest onto that there is one designated person who sits board and at 15 so it doesn't mean you have 15 people calling ke kya hai bhai sales kitne hue hain there will be one individual that you will attract and on a monthly or quarterly basis you will have a call like this where you will brief the other investors about what is happening and in that 1 hour call they could ask you questions and stuff like that but the reason why an investor group like the Indian Angel Network were meant for it investing companies and that's in work because we are able to get experts that we have access to so when if 5 people have entered in a company those 5 people have access to about 250 other investors who are able to provide guidance to your venture and about 600 external mentors that we have access to so for example Sanchindani of Nokri could any or Deep Kalra could I mean member but Sanjeev has 8 VPs in his company head of sales head of technology head of marketing head of media people head of what I think so mentored if you are selling a online platform that has B2B sales but are used by users and you want to understand six cities business one of your investors may not necessarily be expert in that domain or may not have a understanding of the challenges but they can easily call up being a member of the network they can call up a member like you know is need to talk to one of your process guys on understanding kya hota kaise hai in the healthcare space because we'll use the so can you just ask your head of sales of technology to and head of operations to make an hour with them. The kind of mentoring and then some where you can get some understanding. Some cases could be long term it could be more formal and more you know involved last question is what was your experience at TIE well you know it's a fantastic organization I've been involved with TIE now for the last 10-12 years I've taken a year sabbatical in 2004-5 to run the office It's a similar organization, and by the way, most of our, or no, not most, founding team members of the Angel Network are members of in various different capacities. Tai helps people with a whole bunch of things, including mentoring. So, folks, if I think we are done in terms of time, we are, I think, 15 minutes ahead of that. Thank you much for being patient listeners. If there are any questions, write to me at my mail ID, prajakt@indianangelnetwork.com. Do visit my blog, it's thehubforstartups.wordpress.com. And I write on Quora if anybody is on Quora. Feel free to connect with me. I respond to everything that comes into my desk. Thank you very much. Have a good evening.